As you're aware, coronavirus, or COVID-19 as it is called, has become a pandemic, or declared as a pandemic by the World Health Organization. Fortunately for us in India, the number of cases are very few, considered that our population is 1.3 billion plus. And very few people have been seriously affected, and only a couple of deaths so far. But it's still a disease that we need to be aware of, be alert to, but not to be panicking about. The government has taken extraordinary steps in curbing this disease. And there are a few things about this disease that you need to know. First of all, it's a respiratory illness. And there are two main ways it spreads. One is direct contact with someone who's coughing or sneezing, and that too within a distance of 1 to 2 meters. Close contact with someone who has a respiratory illness is coughing and sneezing in one way. The second important way is it spreads through contaminated surfaces. So if you are sitting or walking around and you're coughed and sneezed, viral droplets may be on the surface like the table, chairs, door handles, elevator buttons, so on and so forth. So we have to be careful about a few things. One is, if you have a cold and cough, please stay away from public places so that you do not infect others. Second is frequent cleaning of your hands, either with soap water, liquid soap, or a sterile end is very, very important, because what happens is your hands may be contaminated and you touch your face, mouth or nose, you're likely to get the disease. And also make sure the surfaces that you come in contact with are cleaned repeatedly. Now, what we see is that people have started panicking, which is not what they should do. I see a lot of people walking on the roads of Bangalore and other cities with a mask. And this is, to me, a misuse of masks. Masks are indicated in very, very few cases. One is for medical healthcare workers who take care of patients with respiratory illness. Two, if you have a cold and cough, obviously you need to wear a mask so that you don't spread it to others. And maybe when you go to very crowded places where you do not know what kind of people you come in contact with, there is some role for a mask. But certainly no role in the general areas where you walk around the streets with a mask. It's a waste of resources. Please do not misuse the mask so that people who actually need the mask have it. Now, in general, what is very, very important is that we need to increase our hygiene levels, what we call as the hygiene quotient. One is certainly greeting with the traditional namaste is far, far better and what we should use rather than the handshake or hugging, which is known to spread the disease. Second is that use the cough etiquette. Whenever you're coughing or sneezing, use a tissue or a kerchief or at least your elbow so that you directly do not cough into someone's face. And then you can dispose of the tissue after that. And please wash your hands or clean your hands repeatedly soon after you cough or touch anything. If you take these measures, it's unlikely that disease will spread. Now, it's also very, very important that the government, the private sector, and the citizens work together in trying to prevent the spread of this disease. It's very, very important that the citizens are an important part of containing this disease. Because what is most important in containing this disease is what we call as self-regulation and isolation and quarantine at home. Most people with this disease do not need to come to the hospital and do not crowd the hospitals unnecessarily and sort of stretch their resources. So most of the times, a home quarantine for someone who is sick is very, very good so that you don't spread it to others. So unless the citizens are more alert, are more conscious and have a civic sense, then the disease is likely to spread. But as of now, do not panic. Just be alert. The chance of you dying of corona is less than you being struck by lightning. Now, the government has set up very, very standard protocols for the diagnosis and also containment of the coronavirus. One is, if you feel you are sick or you have been in contact with someone who has a coronavirus, or you have to have traveled to a destination which has a high incidence of corona, then obviously you will be screened when you enter the country. And then if you are in the country and you develop any of these symptoms, please go to the government authorized hospitals, which is most government hospitals and private sector hospitals, where based on your history and physical examination, the doctors will decide whether you need to be tested for corona or not. As of now, all the testing is done in the government labs only, and only the specimens are collected at these hospitals and sent to the government labs where the testing is done, and then the information is given to the concerned health authority. It is all government approved labs, and the ultimate final destination is the NIV in Pune. Now, what is very important to know is that the government has been very proactive and has come up with extraordinary measures in trying to prevent corona from spreading. And also the protocols are very, very clear cut. What we do is, as I said, if you have or if you think you have corona, you go to a designated hospital. If you are sick, the hospital will check you up and certainly get your specimens for corona checking. If you are reasonably okay, they'll send you home and the health authorities are informed who will supervise your quarantine at home. Secondly, if you are sick, then you will get admitted to a hospital or an ICU depending on how sick you are. And of course, there is no need for every patient to be admitted, but self-quarantine and containment is the key. And we would recommend that most people practice self-regulation and quarantine if they think they are sick or have the coronavirus, rather than crowd the hospitals which are already stretched.